My name is Malika Abouenia, and I joined the cholera team as the focal as the OCV focal point in 2019, and I will provide you an overview of the use of the cholera vaccine in 2021. As presented Frank this afternoon, we will discuss about the response outbreak, the challenge in terms of response outbreak. There will be description of the outbreak, so I will not spend too much time on that. There will be description of the use of the vaccine and all the challenges. I will give an overview general. We will have also an update from our colleague Antonia Andonov from UNICEF SD, who will provide an update on the stockpile. And there will be also a presentation from Justine Hack from the cholera team, the WASH focal point, on the use of the WASH activities that can be implemented during emergency campaigns. So I will start by give you some preliminary data of the outbreak in 2021. As you can see on the slides, in terms of cases, it was increased. The number of cases was increased compared to the last year, where the year of COVID, where the surveillance system was affected. In total, 130,000 cases were reported in Africa. And in the world, it was around 160,000. Most of those cases were reported also in Nigeria. On the second slide in the middle, it shows the number of deaths. And in 2021, we can see that already 4,000 deaths were reported. It's only preliminary data, but the death in 2021 represent a high number. Looking at the CFR, the global CFR was 2.5% and 3.1% in Africa. I will give you an overview of the request. So since the creation of the stockpile, around 178 million doses were requested, and 42% represent requests for preventive campaign, knowing that since 2016, doses are provided for preventive campaigns. In 2021, you can see on the graph, we received two preventive requests for Yemen and for Ethiopia that represent 9.7 million doses. And there was eight requests for emergency requests. Bangladesh, Ethiopia, three requests, Nepal, Niger, and two for Nigeria. In the graph below, in blue, we presented the number of cases reported in 2021 and the CFR. And you can see that in the quarter three, there was a significant increase in terms of requests. In terms of reported cases. And we can see in the graph on the right that this had an impact on the request. And we received in the quarter three of the year around 12 million doses of requests. In terms of approved doses, in total, it was since the beginning of the stockpile, we approved 132 million doses in total. Half, almost half of it was approved for preventive requests. In 2021, it's 30 million doses that were approved, most of them for reactive campaigns. There will be a presentation from UNICEF of the shipment. I just wanted to show here the countries where we shipped the doses since 2013. And the country where we ship more doses is more DRC, followed by Nigeria, and then and then Ethiopia. This map shows the countries' reported cases in 2021 and the vaccination campaign. So in total, 15 countries reported cholera cases this year, and campaigns were implemented in 9 countries. You can see in green the preventive campaigns, and in red, the reactive campaigns. So at the beginning of the year, many preventive campaigns were implemented in DRC, Malawi, Zambia, and Uganda. So we were delivering more doses for preventive campaign. After quarter three, there was an outbreak in the West, West Africa, in Nigeria. Also, Cameroon reported some cases. And large requests were requested in order to do a response on cholera in this country. So in this region, Niger, Nigeria, and Cameroon, cases are reported since 1970, and there are major outbreaks that occurred almost every 3-4 years in this region. The last outbreaks were reported in 2010, 2011, then 2014, 2015, 2017, and 2018, and the last one this year in 2021. 5 million people are estimated to live in outbreak-prone areas in those countries. So I will want to show some key issues that we still face. So it's still challenging to implement campaigns during the COVID situation. We could see, and today it's still difficult to travel and to have staff dedicated to work on that. The global community should continue to reinforce the message that the roadmap should prevent cholera. And some campaigns are also delayed sometimes because there is also some COVID campaigns that have to be implemented, and the two calendar has to match. We definitely still need to improve the OCV applications implementation. We still receive some requests. We still need to improve the quality of the request. A lot of work is done to support countries in the development of the request. And we are working on a guidance on how to fill preventive and ICG requests. We still have late submissions and implementation. It will be interesting to see what are the challenges when countries will show what are the challenges in implementation. Some campaigns are implemented after the peak and even sometimes after the outbreak. So it's still a challenge. We need to improve the quality of the campaigns, having more monitoring and evaluation. As of today, we still do not have enough information on the adverse events following the immunizations, the number of cases also following the vaccination, the impact itself somehow of the campaign. And although more coverage surveys were implemented this year, it's still challenging to have systematic coverage survey to know the coverage of one, two, or at least one dose. We are facing difficulties to balance supply and demand. As you could see on the graph that I showed in the quarter three, in June, July, we had received a lot of requests, and we are still trying to balance that and to adapt the stockpile, to adapt the doses that we have in order to respond to emergency campaigns first and then to preventive campaigns. As of today, we still have some countries that are on alert. Cameroon will submit soon a request for emergency campaigns. Mozambique also. And there are outbreaks that are still occurring. So the next step is we need to increase the preventive request. Some countries presented this morning, for those who were present, the plans of vaccination for the coming years. So what is very important is to develop the NCPs, but to have clear plans of planned campaigns is very important. And we're trying to really do a lot of work on that. We still need also to encourage the collaboration from the different sectors. Funds were still needed, and were showed this morning that some funds are also needed for that. We plan to implement trainings in French and in English on the whole OCV. In terms of requests, how to do a request, whether it's preventive or for reactive, trainings for implementation of the campaigns, how to prepare a campaign, and the monitoring and evaluation, how to monitor the campaigns. We plan to have to. We are working on implementing trainings next year. And we are also developing a package of training in many languages for the request and the implementation of the campaigns. And we need to improve the time of the implementation of the campaign and the reporting. So as I said, with better training and with recruitment of some staff to be able to be on site to do the request on time, that will help. Thank you.